In 1878, the U.S. Congress allotted $50,000 for a lighthouse to be built at Tillamook Head. One problem. After a survey was taken, it was found out that because of Tillamook Head's height, that the light of the lighthouse would be obstructed by fog. Tillamook Rock was decided to be the next location. In 1879, a survey was taken by H.S. Wheeler. He stated that he was unable to reach Tillamook Rock because of the rough seas and that it would be extremely difficult, if not impossible, to get there, much less build a lighthouse. He was ordered to try again. On his second attempt, he was successful, but had a hard time moving his surveying equipment from his ship onto the island, but he finished the survey. He concluded that to make a level surface for the lighthouse, much blasting would be required, and that the entire project would require more money than originally allotted. In September of 1879, another survey was ordered, this time conducted by a man named John Trewavas. But poor John was swept away to sea when he was hit by a wave while attempting to get onto the island. John's assistant, a man named Cherry, dove in after him but was unable to rescue John. Cherry himself was almost lost too, but was rescued by others on the ship. John's body was never found. Charles Ballantyne replaced John, but like the other surveyors before him, he ran into a problem. He couldn't hire any locals to level a space on the island for construction. The locals might have refused for three reasons: John's death, they thought it was an impossible task, and the legends about the island. Local Native Americans believed that the island was cursed by the gods, and that there were tunnels haunted by evil spirits. Charles finally was able to hire some quarrymen that were not from the area. He sequestered the crew in the keeper's cabin at Cape Disappointment until they could be transported to the island. Charles did this to keep the locals from scaring away the crew with any stories. This worked and the crew made it onto the island, but shortly after beginning work, they were stranded for 2 weeks. During that time, they were attacked by sea lions and almost froze and starved to death. Despite this, work continued, and on May 31st, 1880, a spot had been leveled and construction could begin. H.S. Wheeler, the first surveyor, became the official in charge of construction. In early January of 1881, high winds and a thick fog came in. Wheeler heard panicked voices of men who were not his crew and noticed a ship dangerously close to the shore. He ordered his crew to place lanterns in the newly constructed tower and to light a bonfire to warn the ship. It worked because the ship turned around and went back to sea. The ship was the Lupitia, and unfortunately the next day, all 16 crew were found dead, washed up on the shore of Tillamook Head. The only survivor of the wreck was the crew's dog. Later, lighthouse keepers would witness the phantom Lupitia. One even wrote of his experience in his book called Tillamook Rock. Construction was finished on January 21, 1881 at the cost of $125,000, $3.25 million today. At the time, it was the most expensive lighthouse to be built on the West Coast. The tower's incandescent oil vapor lamp was lit and the Fresnel lens shone bright. 4 men were assigned to work the lighthouse without their families. Some believe that these original keepers went insane, but I couldn't find any evidence of this. Duty at the lighthouse was certainly hard due to the isolation and the almost constant bad weather. This is why the lighthouse earned the nickname Terrible Tilly. Do not forget to leave a like and subscribe if you have enjoyed this video. And if you already have, thank you very much.